and somewhat out of the fact that the Magic are taller at those guards positions and you can post them up.
Trying to get Hardaway as many punches right now as they can with Iverson on it. Boy, Iverson does not want to shoot the three-pointer right now. Harvey Grant to the basket. Harvey had 6 points in the opener last night in Charlotte. That's his first bucket tonight. We're tied at 9.
It's interesting, this offense the Magic are running right now, giving Bo the opportunity to handle the basketball. Very nice, Bo, at the point guard spot.
Yeah, put him out there up top and just let him go to work, Goose. Not too bad. The point forward.
Yeah, that's what it is. And once again, with Penny and Nick having a size advantage down low, that enables them to get to the low post.
Nice. You know, because right now Iverson is just head faking. He has, appears to have no intent to shoot the basketball from outside. I'd be surprised if the Magic buy any of his head fakes.
Well, you know you have to respect him, though, David, because he can knock down the shot from the outside. So while you get in a lot of trouble forcing him to put the ball on the floor, there's Ratliff right there.
And a good hustle by Harvey Grant to knock it free. Ratliff, he is one of the top shot blockers in the NBA. Still a young guy, only 25 years old. Theo Ratliff is the second all-time leading NCAA shot blocker behind Alonzo Mourning. You can understand how.
You see him coming over from the weak side. I think that is, he has great timing.
Penny draws the contact, and the foul is called against 20-year-old Larry Hughes.
Boy, and he does look young.
Baby face. He is a talent, though. You talk with Larry Brown. He loves this guy.
Well, I was impressed that the first thing out of Larry Brown's mouth about this guy is what he does on the defensive end of the floor and the fact that he knows the game so well. He didn't even talk about what he can do on the offensive end. And just think about it. How many guys come out of college, particularly this young, that you hear the first thing about their defense? And how much they understand the game. So I think that is a huge advantage of a lot of young guys that come out.
Penny is 4 out of 4 on the free throw line. Yeah, Hughes was the college freshman of the year last year at the University of St. Louis and left for the NBA after one season of college basketball. He's got the ball now against Penny Hardaway. And the entry pass almost gets out of bounds. Ratliff saved it, and the Magic turn it right back over to Philadelphia. It's turnover city early in this ballgame. 3:03 to go in the quarter. Chuck Daly just shaking his head on the sideline.
I think this goes down so far as ugly, I guess, this game. Not just the Magic, both teams a little reckless and careless with the basketball.
Well, both clubs played last night. The Magic got into Philadelphia at about 3 a.m. There's another steal by Outlaw into the hands of Darrell Armstrong. 3-on-3, now 4-on-3 as Penny joins the play, and he scoops it in.
Well, good job, Darrell Armstrong, because Darrell will give him a little bit of energy on the fast break.
Hardaway has 10 of Orlando's 15 points. Long shot by Hughes is no good, and Outlaw's called for a foul.
Well, that's tough call right there, and the thing is, I think it's right.
That's Bo's second personal also. It's going to put the rookie on the line to shoot three. Penny leading the Magic. It's a 4-point Orlando lead early.
Magic tickets are available now. Call Ticketmaster at 407-839-3900.
Get ready to taste life for the first time, people.
Watch out now. You want to taste life? Then take a big swig of this. New Pepsi One. This one's got it all. The most awesome cola taste. That's bigger than the Wild Blue Yonder. But only one calorie. You want to taste one?
Yeah.
You want one?
Yeah.
You want one?
You got one for me?
Put your tray table up and prepare for takeoff, my man.
All the taste, one calorie. Only one has it all.
Got an old buddy waiting for a visit in Washington?
With everyday low fares on Southwest Airlines, flying the BWI is your best route to the capital.
You are now free to move about the country.
Hey,
Whether you enjoy working out in the afternoon sun, keeping up with your kids as they run all over town.
Mom, hurry up!
Working up a sweat, swinging to the beat of the music.
Or even playing a little one-on-one.
Find time to be active. The reward isn't just a strong body, but a healthy way of life.
Welcome back to Philadelphia. We are late in the first quarter. Horace Grant and the Magic lead the 76ers 15-11. Matt Harpering, the rookie from Georgia Tech, checks into the Magic lineup. So it'll be Hardaway, Armstrong, Harpering, Grant, and Austin on the court for the Magic. Rookie Larry Hughes is on the line. He turned 20 just last week.
And misses the first. Bo picked up his second foul just before that timeout as he got Hughes on the arm from behind the three-point line, so Hughes has three coming. The Magic now have forced the 76ers into six turnovers, David. And they have been able to get out on the break some because of that.
Larry Hughes last night in Charlotte played only 16 minutes. He had 11 points and 9 rebounds. And now has 2 in the first period for Philadelphia tonight. The Magic lead is 2. Armstrong now matches up with Allen Iverson. And Hughes matches up with Penny Hardaway. The Magic want to challenge the rookie. Penny going one-on-one with it. Nice spin move. Good defense. Penny missed the shot. Harper kept it alive, and Austin has the rebound. Armstrong to Grant, the 20-footer. Hughes the rebound. Hughes charging down the lane with a left hand. It won't go. Tipped in. Ratliff, I think, is the man who got it. Boy, you see some athleticism on the part of Hughes right there. He took the ball strong to the basket and almost finished it with a left hand. Geiger blocks the shot out of bounds, and the Magic will put it in play with a minute 43 to go in the quarter. Theo Ratliff will check out of the game. As also for the Magic, Michael Doliak will check in. So the Magic have two rookies on the floor at the same time here late in the quarter. Armstrong on the drive, the runner. Rattles in for Darryl. Oh, he had 15 points last night in the opener against the Knicks. Despite the injuries, the calf injury, a bruised calf, an Achilles problem as well, but Darryl playing very well. Tim Thomas, jump shot over Harpering, no good. The rookie Doliak with the rebound.
David, once again, since Darryl Armstrong has come into the game, you get a faster tempo that seems to be one the Magic like to play at. I think the other thing that happens is he's been able to get closer shots to the basket because of the penetration and Harpering over the bench. He might have taken a forearm or something to the nose. A little bit of blood there on Matt Harpering as he walks back towards the top of the key.
Penny Hardaway aggressively takes the ball to the basket once again there, Jack, and he nice rattles touch. In another free throw. He's played very aggressively on both ends of the floor tonight as Penny Hardaway. Already he has 11 points and is perfect from the free throw line. There you see Harpering running as though Tim Thomas on the shot at the other end. When he raised up, he caught Harpering with either the forearm or the elbow right in the nose.
Well, he has it's red right now, David, and he's going to stay in there. That's though a quality of Matt Harpering. Doesn't want anybody to think they have an advantage, so.
And he gets called for a foul here, does Harpering. Well, I've made the comment that he sticks his nose right in there, and literally he stuck his nose in on the jumper of Thomas and paid the price. And that time he picks up a personal foul, his first. Magic up by 4, Iverson. Nice job by Doliak, recognizing the penetration, cutting Iverson off. And now I think they'll have an illegal defense here on Darryl Armstrong. Maybe Penny down away from the ball.
Well, Penny stayed down in the paint when Hughes took that step to the corner to try to help out as Darryl Armstrong and Iverson were going at each other.
Harvey and Horace were head-to-head for a moment, and then we've got a whistle and a foul, I believe.
Well, that's Penny again.
Called on Hardaway.
I thought Doliak had all ball, and in fact he did. Penny reaches in down low. And there he is, across the arm.
Matt Geiger is now 2 out of 3 at the free throw line. He cuts the Magic lead to 3. Aaron McKee checks in. And Larry Hughes checks out for Larry Brown, 76ers. McKee in his 5th year out of Temple. Star player in high school basketball in the Philadelphia area.
Well, it's interesting. Hughes out of the game quickly, and I think the reason for that is Penny Hardaway had been able to take advantage of him, and Darryl tried to draw the foul there, could not get it.
Thomas from Iverson. Philly cuts the lead to 1.
Thomas can fly. He's another one of those great athletes on this team. But he does a great job of filling the lane. That's where he's really valuable.
Hardaway's had a big first quarter. Shot wouldn't go. Harpering is going to be called for the foul, trying to strip it away from Harvey Grant.
Reaching in from behind, and that's one of those rookie plays you can expect them to make. The bodies are so much bigger on this level. And anytime you reach from behind, you put yourself in jeopardy of getting rung up for a foul.
You'd rather you make Philadelphia earn 2 points here at the end of the quarter rather than stop the clock and let Harvey Grant walk down and shoot 2 free throws. So that was not a good foul by Harper. But on the other hand, if Harvey doesn't make both of them, imagine you get one more possession. He does drop in the first and ties the game at 19. Scott Williams just reporting in. 9th-year player from the University of North Carolina. He's got 3 championship rings.
And probably would have had more had he not complained about not having a bigger role with that Chicago Bulls team. He wanted Horace Grant's starting job, felt he deserved it, and the folks in Chicago didn't agree with him, so they sent him to Philadelphia. Gotta let that one go. Yes, very nice.
Doliak from the free throw line, and the rookie gives the Magic a first quarter lead. Well-executed pick-and-roll by Armstrong and Doliak. And the rookie makes his first shot of the night. So a closely contested first period from Philadelphia. And Michael Doliak gives the Magic a 1-point advantage at the buzzer at the end of the first period.
Constantly searching for lower prices, Team Target travels here to the Great Barrier Reef. Ordinarily timid creatures, the lower prices periodically emerge from their hiding to feed, reproduce, and be arrested. Careful to take only what they need, Team Target ensures there will be abundant low prices today and for the future.
It's a blast. It's a ball. It's a very big ball. Where else can you be? Zip Zap. Shrunk and trapped. 3D and deep blue seed. Bill Nye Tempura Fried. Wowed, loud, and draw a crowd. Oompa, Pod, and Casbah. World toured and Eiffel towered. Robotized and solar powered. Micro shipped on a body trip. Laserized and piratized. Epcot. Where else can you have such a ball?
Miracle.
Hey Orlando, join in. The WNBA is coming to Central Florida as the Orlando Miracle debuts this summer. And a Miracle game is something the whole family can enjoy, with lower bowl tickets starting at just $8.
The fans have got to be excited and enjoy the first year, because there'll never be another first.
So be a part of the excitement as the Miracle begin their inaugural season. For tickets, call 407-916-WNBA.
I'm John Strauss.
The break into this coffin.
My husband's very ill. We're trying to find his family here.
Look who's come back from the dead.
Why are you lying? Where do I come from?
Playing this month on Direct Ticket, only on Direct TV.
Well, Welcome back to Philadelphia. David Steele and Goose Gibbons, and the Magic have a one-point lead at the end of the first quarter. Here's your first quarter stats brought to you by Champion. The Magic 37%, the Sixers 39% from the field. Magic 7 of 8 from the foul line, and Penny Hardaway a perfect 6 of 6. Philly leads the rebounding 14 to 10.
Well, as you could have expected, David, in some of these early games, both teams really struggling in virtually every area. The field goal percentages, the turnovers, both teams have not been nearly as sharp as they were last night.
Magic check Dan Shays into the basketball game. So Shays and Doliak are twin towers for the Magic. Here's Thomas with the steal. Thomas going to take it himself and missed the layup. But the ball is put back up and in by McKee. Billy back on top by a point. Bring off the Doliak screen, and it knocked away by McKee. Shot clock is at 6. Armstrong with the open shot. Anderson the rebound for the Magic. Darryl fires again. He's short again. Doliak fights for the rebound, and Harpering runs it down. Rifles a pass to Shays, and Doliak wasn't ready for it. Thomas folds over Anderson, and it'll be a foul against Nick.
I think the problem there with Nick was he might have been leaning back before the contact occurred. I thought he had pretty good position there, though, David. And the officials rung him up for a block.
Thomas was out of control coming down the lane there. But Anderson, I think you're right. Probably his lean is what got him in trouble. Tim Thomas, another young man who played just 1 year of college basketball at Villanova. And last year was his rookie season. He was the sixth leading vote getter for the all-rookie team, so he was on the all-rookie second team. You see Gerald Wilkins checking in for the Magic for Matt Harpering.
Well, Thomas got off to a slow start last year, David. Really struggled early, but improved as the season went on. And by the end of the year, had turned into a pretty consistent player, Dominique Wilkins. Waiting for his first opportunity to play in a Magic uniform.
Been able to practice with the ball club. Chuck Daly said maybe next week the team will have a couple of practice sessions and he can get Dominique Wilkins ready to go into a game. There's a foul called, it's an illegal defense called against Scott Williams, and that's the second illegal defense called against Philadelphia.
Darryl Armstrong after having a perfect night at the free throw line last night, 8 for 8, will step in and take the free throw.
Say that should earn him the technical free throw honors.
For now, at least. Well, we went through a stretch, was it last season, where it seemed everyone that stepped up there to take a technical foul shot would miss it.
Iverson almost steals the inbound pass. Magic will reload.
I used to always love that technical free throw. I mean, that's one that's just a gift. And it is sometimes the most difficult free throw to make.
Doliak, he's got great range out there, but got one off ball. And then Thomas is fouled by Dan Shays on the rebound. Danny's first. Sixers on top, 24-22.
Doliak bleeding, so he will have to come out of the game. They'll doctor him up there. We'll see. No, Horace is up, and we'll check into the ball game.
So Michael Doliak takes a seat. And looks like he's not in too bad a shape. Trainer Tim Walsh working on him. Getting back in there momentarily. 2-point Philly lead. Thomas against Nick Anderson. Inside to McKee. He goes to work against Gerald Wilkins. And the foul.
Well, that's the shot you want Aaron McKee taking. Falling away from the baseline. From the basket under pressure. Gerald hasn't played pretty well, but as he falls away, I guess Gerald got him with the body or across the arm. Couldn't see it right there. Aaron McKee, though, has a chance for the three-point play here, David.
McKee came to Philadelphia along with Ratliff from Detroit in the Jerry Stackhouse trade. He's got 5 second quarter points already, and the Sixers lead by 5.
McKee is one of those guys you always like to have on your team. He's consistent, every night plays hard, and can defend.
One thing we see already, Jack, about Philadelphia, they're a pretty good defensive club.
Yes, they are. 5 feet.
Shot clock is down to 2. Wilkins has to create something, but the shot won't go. McKee rebounds for Philly. Iverson leads the fast break. And he's hustling back on defense.
Well, once they get the ball, they flat fly down the floor, and Danny Shays commits the foul. Not a veteran-like play that time by Danny Shays, and Michael Doliak back up very quickly. I would assume he will replace Danny Shays.
Ratliff was able to get the shot away before Shays can get to it. Danny picks up his second personal foul, and Theo Ratliff will have a chance to put Philly up by 8.
Green Buddies, I got some bad news. We got canned. They want us off the rocks by the end of the day.
What did you just say?
Canned? Who got canned?
Okay, freeze the swamp. You guys can talk?
Of course we can talk, you bonehead.
What does canned mean?
But all you said was bud and herb.
We were reading from the script. You should try it sometime.
What does canned mean?
Don't be fired.
Canned means fired? I can't breathe. Gonna get sick?
Wait, no, don't get sick.
Getting sick?
Put your head between your legs.
Someone get him a bucket.
Now how is that supposed to sell beer?
Watch this move by the doctor.
I'm a basketball Hall of Famer in large part because of my God-gifted talents. But I worked very hard to develop a fundamental game as well as understand the game mentally. There are many physically gifted players who don't understand the fundamentals and therefore can't succeed. Conversely, there are less talented players who are strong fundamentally and they knock off the big guys. I think the most important thing for a young player is to become fundamentally sound.
Learn the fundamentals at a Magic basketball camp. Call 407-916-2267. Quarter. McKee from 20. And Horace Grant is fouled by Theo Ratliff. Ratliff picked up a foul in the first minute of the basketball game, and there's his second.
They did a good job, David, of avoiding that second foul. I was kind of hoping we might see him get into some early foul trouble so he wouldn't be able to spend as much time on the floor, but played smart, did not pick up his second foul until now, and he will leave the game.
Matt Geiger returns. Theo Ratliff gets a break.
He was awarded, both of those guys, you saw Matt Geiger, you see Ratliff now, both were rewarded with pretty healthy raises from what they made last season.
Both got big contracts. Philadelphia made a commitment to try and put together a championship type team, and Mitch Anderson made a commitment to knock down back-to-back threes for the Magic.
You know, the thing Philly has done, David, they have they added a couple veterans, but they also have done a good job of adding some young guys that will be there for a long time. They also extended Allen Iverson's contract. So between Allen Iverson, Theo Ratliff, and Matt Geiger, and then the young Hughes, they have some pretty decent young talent on this team.
Well, that has been the trend in this lockout short season. Teams locking up their, what they consider their real talent, their big-time talent, for long years.
Well,
Philadelphia has done that.
I think it makes it very easy now for players to understand, to see that you are limited as to how much you can make, so holding out for more is not going to benefit you at all. So they are doing it, getting players re-signed.
Iverson puts the Sixers up by four. Inside of 8 minutes to play here in the second quarter from Philadelphia. Armstrong and Iverson battling. The Magic want to get the ball to Austin down low against Geiger. Two players the Magic took a look at in the offseason. And Austin wins that individual battle. And it's a two-point game. Iverson flying down the floor. Grant blocked his shot, but somebody got him with the body. I don't know if it was Ike or Horace. They're going to give it to Horace Grant.
Now, you could give either one of them the block as well. Ike does a good job getting out of the way and then comes over and gets him. Horace, I guess, got him from behind. Gets himself two free throws.
Somebody got him, I guess. Iverson winds up at the line. Once again, he shoots a lot of free throws. Last year, he shot 535 foul shots. The league leaders in that category.
Yes. Hughes back into the ball game. He will be matched up with Gerald Wilkins. Maybe an opportunity for the Magic to give Gerald the ball on the low post and see if he can take advantage of the youngster.
Iverson a perfect 4 out of 4 at the line tonight. Penny Hardaway is getting an extended break here after playing a marvelous first period. Austin brought the contact. Philly really stretching out Orlando's offense, and the Magic did a nice job of spreading the floor and finding the open man at the basket.
Philly has a lot of quickness on the floor, and what they're doing now is some run and jump defense. As they come with the weak side help out on the high post, and the ball's out high to try to force the Magic to scramble to use some time on the shot clock. Horace Grant got it, found Ike Austin under the basket. A real nice look in towards the basket from Horace Grant that time.
Ike Austin now with 5 points in the ball game, and that free throw cuts the Philly lead back to 2. And McKee handles the ball out top against Gerald Wilkins. Iverson off of a Geiger screen. Now they run the pick and roll. Geiger's got a good count of range. He'll put it on the floor and shoot it off the dribble. And Hughes misses the follow. Austin the rebound for the Magic.
You see, though, how Hughes picks up a lot of his rebounds. Very good around the offensive boards. Nichols wide open.
Got the ball a little too late to score. Andre back down to rookie, and we've got an illegal defense, and that'll be another technical foul against Philadelphia. So the Magic are going to get another technical foul free throw, as they have cut Philadelphia's lead to 2.
61. One calorie.
This tastes great.
True cola taste.
Pancakes!
Life's full of choices. Red or blue.
Pancakes or waffles.
A new Beetle or $500. Why choose? Get them both with the Orlando Sentinel. Sentinel Classifieds, your number one source for cars, wants to give you $500 and a key that could start a new Beetle. Get entry forms inside Sunday editions of the Sentinel from local retailers, vendor boxes, and Goodings. Send one in every Sunday. Each week, you could win $500 plus a chance to win a new Beetle. So why choose? Get it all with Sentinel Classifieds.
The wind howled through the trees. The monster had escaped. Danger lurked around every corner. He could be anywhere. Even inside the house.
What happened to the monster?
Let's read something else.
Yeah, are you scared?
It was a beautiful day.
Don't be afraid to read to your kids.
With a one-point lead. They led by eight just a moment ago at 30-22, but Orlando is on an 11-4 run. Now the Southwest Airlines league leader. This is from last year. Scoring leaders, Michael Jordan, Shaq second, Karl Malone, Mitch Richmond of Sacramento, now playing in Washington. And the field goal leaders from last year, Shaq led the league in that category. Bo Outlaw was second. Mourning and Duncan round out the top four. There's 97-98 leaders in steals show Iverson in the number five spot. Mookie Blaylock led the league in that category. And Larry Brown and his coaching staff.
Maurice Cheeks.
He
played
had a few
lot
steals
of years
in his
yes,
career, didn't
yes,
he?
Yes, he did.
6.5 minutes to play in the second quarter.
Now here's the matchup I was talking about, David, to see how the young guy is going to handle a little one-on-one.
Lopez made a nice move and kept it alive. Austin shot with go. Looked like it might have been Dolphin if somebody had a hand up in the net.
I think you're right, David.
But there was no call. And the Sixers perhaps get a break there. They still lead by one. Armstrong hits the technical free throw.
Well, Ratliff makes you change your shot. You shoot it quickly, you know he's down there.
Not only long, but he's quick. Quick jumper with those long arms. And Austin gets called for a foul, a shove, says referee Ronnie Nunn. That's his first. And it'll put Geiger on the free throw line. Penny Hardaway returns to the Orlando Magic lineup as Geiger will shoot two. Struggling on the line tonight. That's only 2 out of 5. Here's Penny. Hardaway had 12 first quarter points and then got himself a nice break. He probably could have used it. He played 41 minutes last night.
Right. You know, I know it's early, David, but this backcourt with Daryl and Penny, it was effective last night, and it was here in this game.
Great drive by Armstrong. He beats
very
Iverson
nice.
And avoids the block shot. And Daryl now has 6 points in the basketball game. Magic tie it up.
Daryl got around the corner, saw the defense was had his back to him, just took it right onto the hole.
Iverson to Snow. Nice bounce pass to Geiger. Horace is there, but Geiger lays it in. Penny reached up and he hit his bomb or his hand. Up on the backboard. He's in some pain.
I think what he did, David, was he went up to block the shot and he got his hand caught up in the rim.
Flexing that hand, you can see him there on the right side of the floor. Austin's bad pass. It was deflected. Now Philly's in a run out. And Armstrong was there and an offensive foul is called. No basket. Iverson picks up the personal.
Just a little surprised that the whistle went that way. I thought Allen Iverson would definitely get the benefit of the whistle here, but Daryl Armstrong, look at the effort by Daryl. He just comes in and, yeah, there he is. You saw it, a little bit of push off there. See him push Daryl Armstrong off. Daryl pulled his arm back. Definitely no contact from Daryl. And Penny is out of the game.
Tim Walsh having a busy first half. Anderson on Austin again. Austin again inside. Looks for the foul line. He drills it.
Well, Wojcik's playing, you'd be much better off to just clear it out and let him go, because he made a couple of three-point shots, and he has that look in his eye like, hey, let me have a shot or two here, guys, and he takes advantage of that one.
Iverson has not pulled the trigger out there much tonight, and that one won't fall. Nick with the rebound.
Not a good pass that time by Bill.
Here he goes again. Behind the back to Geiger. He couldn't find the handle, and then a foul is called against Bill.
If Allen Iverson will come out of the game here, I don't know. Aaron McKee up very quickly, and I thought it might have been a travel, just simply, there's Penny hitting his hand on the rim. I thought there might have been a travel by Geiger, because he just kind of fumbled it as he went on to the basket.
Right. Sloppy play. Geiger manages to still wind up at the free throw line, and he's now 4 out of 7.
Iverson out of the game. I don't know that Larry Brown was real happy with the pass. I don't know really that it was his fault. I thought it was a pretty decent pass, not handled by Geiger.
1 out of 2 for Geiger again on the line. Anderson's double teamed in a hurry. It looked like Randall got there off quickly. And Sturr gets the rebound. Geiger, shooting at the other end, gets the easy bucket.
That running at Hart Grant right now. Hart's is shooting it a little bit quickly. And kind of lost control of that one as he went up.
Armstrong and Anderson pick and roll.
Tough.
There's another steal. And the rookie's off and running. His first field goal tonight. Billy by 5. And Chuck Daly wants timeout. Couple of perilous passes and turnovers resulting in Philly buckets, and the Sixers have taken advantage. They lead by 5. We are late in the second quarter from Philadelphia.
Check your local listings for One Magic Place every Sunday morning at 11.
While there are a lot of places where people buy parts for their car, the fact is more people choose AutoZone than any other. It's because we're the largest auto parts retailer in America, and they save money with our everyday low price. It's because more often than not, we have the parts they need in stock. And it's because we're the only place where they'll find a battery that's backed by a 3-year free replacement guarantee. Which is why we say there's just no place better than AutoZone.
Let me show you how to pick a right melon. It's got to be soft, like Todd's head.
Hey, what you got there?
Cat food.
You mind dropping that for us? It's hot in here. I'm sweating.
Look at the size of you. Drop a few pounds.
At least I'm not a little shrimp runt like you. Serve you in frozen food, have you with cocktail sauce tonight.
Easy.
Check out our Solar Bears ticket packages starting as low as $66. Call 407-872-PUCK.
Hey, Todd, you got fresh malanga root.
The people of CARE know that there are thousands of families around the world who face starvation, who need clean water to avoid fatal diseases, and who need the tools to learn to help themselves. But as the NBA's Dikembe Mutombo has seen in his homeland of Africa, a little care can make a world of difference.
Show that you care.
We're back in Philadelphia. The Magic have inbounded the ball and gets quickly inside to Ike Austin, and Ike is fouled on his shot. He'll get to the free throw line to shoot a pair.
The Magic continue to give Philly extra opportunities with their turnovers, David.
5 and a quarter, I think.
And 9 overall. Philly just with 2, but they do have 8 overall as far as the turnovers are concerned. Ike Austin gets 1 of 2.
Austin cuts the lead back to four. Magic made a substitution during the timeout. Wilkins checked in for Darryl Armstrong. That moves Hardaway back out to the point guard. Snow gives it to Geiger. A tough turnaround jumper, and he backs it in. Good use of the backboard by Matt Geiger that time. He's got 10, and the Sixers lead is 6. Hardaway isolated with Snow. Nice look by Grant down low to Austin for the easy basket.
Yeah, that was really good look for Mike Austin. He saw the defense shift over and left that path open to the basket. Horace Grant now with a couple of real nice feeds down to Ike Austin.
Randolph back in the game. He'll try and work it against Horace Grant. No double team for Grant. Randolph moving all around underneath that basket. And rebound Nick Anderson. Nice job by Randolph just to work himself free for a shot. It's a four-point Philly lead. The Magic with the ball. Wilkins got rejected by Randolph.
And that's very close to goaltending there.
Hughes throws the ball out of bounds.
Well, and you saw Larry Brown pull Allen Iverson out after his kind of fancy behind-the-back pass. Now, he doesn't bring the rookie out right here. Hughes, tried to dress it up a little bit too much, but you pull a rookie out in that situation, and you really hurt his confidence, so Larry Brown's going to leave him in there.
Hardaway going right at Iverson. There's no double team help. Penny goes to the hoop, gets to Austin. He missed it, but Grant was there to get the rebound. Horace surrounded by three defenders. It won't go. Penny puts it back in.
Once again, I tell you what, Theo Ratliff is not going to have many blocks in this game, maybe. But I can't tell you how many shots he's changed around. He's on the line, I think, isn't he? Yeah, so the ball goes the other way.
I think Grant let up defensively because he saw Iverson step out of bounds. That's what he was pointing to referee Tim Donaghy.
And well, the Magic will get it going the other way, take the basket away. You'll see Iverson right here, right there, and there steps on the line.
Only twice
actually, so...
.14 to go in the quarter. Hardaway shot no good, but he was fouled. And Penny back to the free throw line.
Almost a good acting job by Allen Iverson. The problem is he never did get caught up with Penny.
Foul was called against McKee. And Penny goes to the free throw line for the first time in the second quarter.
Now this is about as close as Allen Iverson has been to us. I've been trying to figure out the designs in his hairdo, and still can't figure it out. Kind of looks like a maze.
And don't forget to watch that 10th anniversary special coming up. There is tomorrow at 11 on West Channel 2. It'll be a good show, Goose. You and I were
it was fun.
It was fun.
Carter
Tate, John Gabriel's there. Pat Williams.
Oh, very nice
tonight by Najee Muhammad, the rookie out of Kentucky. You know something about him, don't you, Goose?
Well, yeah, the thing I know more than anything is I wish he had stayed at Kentucky another year.
The boys might have beaten the Gators the other night.
Yeah, they might have.
Nice feed inside, and then a foul is called before the shot on Scott Williams.
Or they might have beaten Alabama today. Two straight losses for my Wildcats.
They've lost two in a row now. Florida, not that big of a surprise, but I was a little bit surprised
I
to
was
see them
as well.
Get beat today by Alabama. Austin at the free throw line. Inside of a minute to go in the quarter. And it's a four-point Philadelphia lead. I'm following up a solid performance last night with another good showing this evening. Another substitution. Here comes Anthony Parker. Young man out of Bradley. In his second NBA season, Iverson checks out. Doliak gets the rebound, but he's going to be called for a push.
Little bit of a push by Michael Doliak. Not much, but he got caught. That's a rookie kind of call.
Well, don't forget at halftime, the Bell South halftime is a feature on the DeVos family's history with the Magic organization. Rich DeVos, Bob Vanderwein will talk about their purchase of the team along with their favorite Magic memories. And, of course, tomorrow at 11 on West Channel 2 in Orlando, you can watch that 10th anniversary special, an hour-long special, which will chronicle the first decade of Magic basketball history. Muhammad knocks in the free throw.
They have Muhammad listed at 221. Actually, looks just a little bit heavier than that, I guess, but done a good job with his weight.
And he gets the ricochet rebound out of the free throw line off the missed shot. It's a four-point lead. Long shot by Hughes. He comes up short. Muhammad is out of bounds trying to hustle the ball down.
Say what, Muhammad giving him some hustle points so far in this game.
Well, they've gotten good production from the bench. Their bench has outscored the Magic's bench 20-8 in the first half. Still a close basketball game, though. The Magic certainly not playing up to their capability nearly as well as they did last night. Still only down by four. Wilkins, Doliak run the pick and roll. Good strong double team. Doliak hammered. Nice. Scott Williams got him, and Michael will shoot two.
Well executed play that time. The double team came. Michael Doliak made the roll to the basket and gets himself opportunity from the line for two. Tell you what, you see all these young guys coming out. I think when you look at what Tim Duncan was able to do last season down at San Antonio, and you look at the rookies we have added this year, and no question you benefit from those extra years in college.
Well, the Magic benefiting from the maturity of Michael Doliak and Matt Harper.
Yes.
Harvey Grant, all kinds of substitutions. Harvey Grant in for Nazi Muhammad. Doug Overton has checked in for the first time. He'll match up with former teammate Allen Iverson, who also checked back in. And Doliak is perfect again on the free throw line.
Well, this is one of those times you want to run someone at Allen Iverson because he's at his best in this situation. The court is spread.
And Overton gets called for a hand check foul with 6 seconds to play in the quarter.
Well, that is very interesting. It's a very slight move that really constitutes the call as a foul or not. You can have your hand on, but as soon as you extend that arm, if you get any kind of advantage as you touch out there, it's going to be a quick whistle. I mean, it's interesting because you see so much other contact that you would think there has to be a foul there. And then that, as soon as you put that hand on with the extended arm, the whistle blows.
But the idea is to give these talented athletic guards an opportunity to show their abilities and be more mobile in the open floor. So, you know, you can understand it from that point of view. The Magic take a 20-second timeout as Iverson is good on one out of two from the free throw line. And you know, Goose, all it takes is just a little hand shove, and you can knock a guy like Allen Iverson off course. I guess it's an effort to try and make the game run a little smoother.
It's all about getting points on the board and giving guys an opportunity to show what they can do with the basketball. There's that hairdo I was trying to figure out with Allen Iverson. It's pretty interesting, as you can see from that shot.
Don't forget, coming up at the half, Goose and I will take a look at first half highlights and run down the statistics. Close basketball game. Of course, that'll come after the feature featuring Rich DeVos and Bob Vanderwijk in their discussion of the early years of the Orlando Magic, the development of this franchise.
And another thing, as you look at the crowd here, for those Magic fans, you want to make sure you use ticket number 2.
Monday night.
Game Monday night, ticket number 2.
Boston Celtics in town. That game will be on Sunshine Network. Here's Overton at the drive. He scoops it up and it goes in. It'll count. Count it, says Ronnie Knox.
Well, I don't think Doliak touched it. I'm not sure. But Doliak had his hand up around the basket. I don't know. Who gets credit for the basket? Does Overton get credit for it?
Well, let's see.
Let it roll.
Carry it on through, and we'll see. I don't think he touched it.
He didn't touch it.
Counted for Doug Overton. And that cuts Philly's lead to one. So the Sixers led by as many as eight in the first half. But the Magic rally and trail by just one at the intermission. Halftime coming up in just a moment. Different Philadelphia players scored in the first half. For the Magic, Horace Grant, no first half points after tossing in 14 on opening night last night in Orlando.
Well, I wonder what Horace, if the back-to-backs that we have will be a factor or not. He definitely has not shot the ball well tonight, but the 76ers have been very much concerned with Horace Grant's presence on the floor, and they are running at him immediately, so I think for Horace Grant, just maybe a little pump fake, one quick dribble, and clears himself up for the shot. I look for Horace to shoot it better in the second half.
Boalaw triggers the ball inbounds, and we're underway for Philadelphia. 18 to 1-0. Philly got a big win on the road last night in Charlotte. Magic knocked off the Knicks at home. They're going to make Horace make something out there, and he does.
Well, that helps a lot. That helps the confidence, and Horace did everything he could not to shoot that one, but the defense just kept backing off.
Maybe that'll get the big fella going here tonight offensively.
Well, that one was a little bit closer in. He used that quick dribble and got a little closer to the basket.
Grant looked the baseline shot. Now Anderson had the rebound, knocked away by McKee. George Lynch had it, rejected by Outlaw.
Bo didn't get many minutes in that first half. Played nine and then spent some time on the bench.
Magic missed a good scoring opportunity that time, and now Snow pushes it down the other way. Three by Iverson won't go, and ball lands in the lap of Penny Hardaway, the easiest rebound he'll get tonight.
And he didn't even have to move for that one. It just came right to him. Magic got a lot out of Penny Hardaway in that matchup with Allen Iverson, so we'll see if they go back to that.
Outlaw keeps it alive, and it's knocked out of bounds. It's going to stay with Orlando.
I thought Bo got it, but we'll see if Ronnie Nunn steps in and overrules.
We're going to have a conference.
Well, with this kind of conference, it usually is going to get overruled. You're right. I think Bo might have gotten a hand on it. I'm not sure. Like Austin with the jump shot. And let's see right here. Good call, I think. Hard to tell from that angle.
Still a one-point Magic lead early in the third quarter. Iverson coming off that screen. Snow gets good penetration. Iverson one-on-one, goes baseline. Grant is there to make him change his shot, and then Horace picks up the loose ball rebound.
Magic haven't gotten either guard down on the low post yet. That is something that worked for him in that first half.
Well, they just can't. Mike Austin surrounded, smothered him, and he turned it over. Billy looks to take the lead again. He takes Outlaw baseline. Nice challenge by Grant, but Geiger puts down the jumper.
Maybe that's the thing to do, David. Just catch the ball and shoot it. Don't try to dribble it. Don't try to pass it. Just catch it and shoot it, as Geiger did that time.
He has 12, and Philadelphia seesaws back into the lead. Nice pick and roll. Penny had the open shot, but it won't drop for him. Iverson, one on two. He likes the odds, however, and he scoops it in.
Well, that's really the first time he's been effective in the transition game.
That is only Allen Iverson's third field goal of the ball game. They've given Philadelphia a three-point lead. Bo operating out of that point forward spot. Nick, a quick walk for three. shot up, and they blocked it away again. I think Rattler tripped it once again. Iverson runs down a long pass. 4-2. Rattler the rebound over Ball, and he gives the 76ers a 5-point lead. Chuck Daly up saying, let's get a 20-second timeout and talk things over. And Hardaway calls timeout. Philadelphia's on a 6-0 run.
Well, it's been ugly so far, David. As I mentioned, the Magic got some good play out of their guards in the mismatch, really, of sizes in both of our 1 and 2 positions. But we haven't seen Penny on the low post yet, and Nick was there once, but ended up in the corner, launched up one from behind the 3-point line. So we'll see if they get back to taking advantage of Penny.
Darrell Armstrong getting worked on by strength and conditioning coach Nick Smith. Trainer Timmy Walsh has had a busy night, so has Mick. And the Magic are without Derek Strong tonight. And there's a steal by Lynch on the inbounds pass. And the shot is good. Referee Tim Donaghy took a couple in transition. And a weird-looking play. There's a big smile on the face of the referee, Tim Donaghy. He got his feet tangled up. Maybe you can see it on this replay. Trying to get out of the way of George Lynch.
Oh, Bo Outlaw came up from behind, and Nick Anderson went for the block and hung on the rim to protect himself. That is the reason there was not a technical foul called there.
And the 3-point play by Snow puts Philadelphia up by 8. That matches their biggest lead of the night.
It seems as though the Magic have been in a catch-up position all night.
Really struggling offensively here early in the third quarter. Boston made a nice quick spin, and then the shot no good. Mike battling for the loose ball. He dives to the deck, but Iverson comes away with it. Philly trying to increase its lead to double digits for the first time tonight.
Well, Penny's doing a real good job on Allen Iverson to keep him from breaking him down and getting to the basket. Really, really good job. Darrell Armstrong up.
Well, let's take a look at the Chief Eagle NBA scoreboard. Toronto leading again. They won last night against Boston. Boston trying to get its first victory at home against Cleveland. Atlanta looking to go 2-0. Milwaukee, Charlotte tied up in the third. Early, Minnesota, San Antonio, and later tonight, Houston, Golden State.
And Bose has about run out of his shoe. It's untied there, so they'll have a chance to tie it up here.
Nice defensive job again by the 76ers. They're challenging every pass, every shot. Very quick to rotate out of double teams.
Bell comes in for for Horace Grant, so that means Bo now will drop down to the 4 spot against Geiger. This is the first time Penny's really had it on the low post here.
They run at him quickly with the double team. Geiger chasing him all the way out on the floor. Penny looking for the open man. Armstrong lets it fly, and Philly got the rebound. They're off and running. Lynch may have traveled to that fast break going. He did. Iverson shot won't go, but Rattler's there to follow. It's another loose ball, and Geiger chases it down.
Well, you're seeing a team right now in Philadelphia getting to every loose ball.
They're a little fresher legs than the Magic.
I think so.
Orlando played that 8 o'clock game last night. Didn't get in here until 3 a.m., and they just don't seem to have their legs under them, as Philly does tonight.
Well, they're just not real sharp on the passes either. I remember last night it seemed as though the Magic were deflecting a lot of passes, and here tonight it appears that Philly is the team that is disrupting the offense with the defense.
That foul was on Matt Geiger, his third, but Philadelphia has stretched its lead to 10. We're midway through the third quarter in Philadelphia.
There's something special about the folks who work at Auto.
Magic back in action on Monday night, back in the Orlando Arena, hosting Rick Pitino's Boston Celtics And you can watch it on Sunshine Network starting at 7 o'clock. Don't forget, that's ticket stub number 2 in your Magic season ticket book. Field goals in the quarter.
Boy, it's been tough. The Magic want the 7. And just not having a good time. Good game tonight shooting basketball. Couldn't change as that.
Hardaway cuts the lead back to 8. That's his first score of the third period. Armstrong up challenging Iverson. Gets the ball inside to Ratliff, working against Downwall. Ratliff, tough shot, and Ratliff in.
Oh, that's good defense by Bo Outlaw. Not a whole lot more that can be done there. Theo Ratliff, much taller than Bo, and just used that to his advantage.
Nice ball movement, Hardaway, with the penetration dribble. This shot won't go, and Geiger rebounds for Philadelphia. A 10-point Sixers lead with just inside of 6 minutes to play in the third quarter. Geiger working on Austin. Good job by Ike. Geiger's been throwing those in though tonight. This one won't fall though, and Anderson pulls down the rebound.
Magic not getting any fast break baskets either, David. It just appears as though they are in their half-court game, posting up, and everyone else standing around.
Ratliff blocks another shot. 3-on-3, and Iverson going to pull up and take the jumper.
That shot he'll make later on. I would imagine Iverson would be in pretty good condition, though.
Ratliff has 3 blocks tonight, Deuce, and he probably changed another 9 or 10, and the Magic turned the basketball over. Scott Williams checks in for Matt Geiger. Scott Williams, not the most popular fella in Philadelphia,
no,
is he?
He's not. They have booed him all night.
He did not play too well in his first stint on the floor in the first half. Let's see if he can make this jumper and quiet the crowd. Nope. And the boos grow louder as Armstrong had it knocked away, and the referee says it goes to Philly. Referee Benny Adams standing right there on the play. Armstrong doesn't like the call. Chuck Daly would like an explanation also.
I don't know how he fell down.
Lynch going to fire the jump shot. Magic down by 10, but it could be a lot worse. A lot of time left, even in this third quarter. Hardaway goes down the left baseline, and he's going to be fouled by Eric Snow.
Snow's a pretty good defensive player, David. He did a good job when he was matched up with Nick Anderson. Pushed Nick off the low block and has used his quickness out on the floor against Penny, although Penny. My goodness.
Over and back. Ball just bounced off Darryl's hands, and it is just one of those nights so far for the Magic. Still ample time to turn things around, and they're only down by 10.
The Magic with 13 turnovers all night last night in the game, and tonight they have 13 already.
Rookie Hughes back in the game. Ratliff now out off his feet. Austin came and blocked his shot, but Lynch is there to clean it up. Billy just dominating the board. Nice shot by Anderson, but he couldn't get to the ball in time, and it's going to be out of bounds back to Philly.
Get a look at Ike Austin coming over with the block. Lynch would like to have that one again. Just pulls it out. Nick Anderson almost took it away, but could not.
Still a 10-point lead. Both ball clubs stuck offensively for the last couple of minutes. Hughes wanted to pull the trigger. Now the Magic run 2 men at him, and he turns it over. Armstrong should get a fast break bucket here. He does to Penny.
Now that's what you need right there, David. Some offense that's created through your defense.
Hughes looked like a rookie that time. Nice job by Anderson. You can hear the slap. Anderson got him on the way up. And it'll be a 3-point opportunity for Theo Ratliff. It's that penetration dribble of Iverson that set things up for Theo Ratliff.
Nick just takes a swipe at the ball and
probably didn't alter anything about the shot, but there was a little contact.
A little bit. They heard a little bit of skin over here. Nick tried to take that one away. I think Iverson was in a little bit quick there.
Yeah, the free throw is no good. A lane violation on Iverson. The Magic get the ball side court, trailing now by 10 again.
You'll see him, watch him move right there. So he's in there before the ball even leaves the hand. And gets called for.
Magic working the ball around the perimeter.
They're trying to get Ike Austin against Scott Williams.
Lynch out on the perimeter. The Magic were fortunate to get 2 points that time.
Well, Benny cleaned it up.
Yep. And a foul is called on Hardaway, trying to steal the inbounds pass from Hughes.
Penny very lively, though. You have to like what you see out of Penny, the energy level.
Trying to pick up his team. They're really struggling tonight. The second half of what is going to be many back-to-backs in this shortened NBA season.
Yes, it is.
Still, the ball club only down by 8 with still 3:12 to play in the third quarter.
Plenty of time for the Magic to get back in this one, but you have to cut down on that turnover total.
Field goals in the quarter, not a pretty sight for either team. A good hustling play by Hardaway, deflecting the ball out of bounds in front of Hughes. Iverson getting a break along with Ratliff on the Sixer bench. Geiger back in there, battling Austin. Geiger lowered his shoulder into Ike, and Ike got called for the foul. Nope, Penny with the reach. So that'll be Penny's third personal. And the fourth team foul against the Magic in the period. I don't think it's a shooting foul, so when we come back, Philly should be inbounding the ball side court. Leading by 8. We'll be back.
The Solar Bears are in it to win it. For tickets, call Ticketmaster at 407-839-3900.
Get ready to taste life for the first time, people!
Watch out now! You want to taste life? Then take a big swig of this new Pepsi One. This one's got it all. The most awesome cola taste that's bigger than the Wild Blue Yonder! With only 1 calorie. You want to taste one?
Yeah!
You will like it!
Regular cola drinkers, diet drinkers, everyone loves the taste. Try it. Tell us what you think, and you could be on your way to the NCAA Final Four.
Got an old buddy waiting for a visit in Washington?
With everyday low fares on Southwest Airlines, flying the BWI is your best route to the capital.
You are now free to move about the country.
And so the detective said the butler didn't do it. It was...
My book!
Let's go, sir.
Where's that page? Gotta finish my book.
Hello, sir. Can you please tell me how your book ends?
No!
We got next, and it's time for you to join in. The Orlando Miracle begin their inaugural season this June. Now the chance for you to catch every heart-stopping, buzzer-beating minute by becoming a Miracle season ticket holder. If you'd like more information, call 407-916-WNBA.
David, you consider the fact the Magic shooting 38% in this game. 19 of 50 is all they've been able to make here, and this game is still far from being over. You would just have to think if they could put together any kind of run, they'd be right back in it.
And 6 turnovers in the quarter have not helped the cause. Geiger makes both free throws, and the Sixers are back up by 10 again. Illegal defense on Scott Williams of Philly, and that will be another technical foul. This will be the third technical foul free throw on illegal defense shot by the Magic tonight. much to the dismay of Larry Brown. Well, what a career. 26 years in coaching, 9 different teams. Armstrong made the technical shot. Coaching career began with the Carolina Cougars. Actually, his first coaching job was Davidson College, and he quit before his first game because the school wouldn't change the carpet in his office.
Well, is that right?
And then Donnie Walsh, his friend who played with him in North Carolina, said, "You're never going to get another coaching job." Well, he went on, obviously, to become one of the all-time greats. Great entry pass from Austin, and Penny Hardaway throws it down.
And that's another part of Ike Austin's game, David. We haven't talked a whole lot about his ability to pass the basketball.
And he's trying to put some pressure on. And Hughes with the jump shot, it won't go. Armstrong, a hustling rebound. It's an 8-point, 7-point game, rather. The Magic on the run. Hardaway. They double-team him out on the floor. Billy doing a lot of scrambling, running, and crashing defense. All night long. Shot clock is down to 7. Austin backing, turning. Hardaway got the rebound, and he fouled as he turns and puts the shot back up.
Penny taking over right now. He is almost by himself keeping the Magic in this game. You'll see him just snake his way in there for that one and gets Snow to foul him from behind.
Hardaway's first of 2 is no good. He made 6 in a row and has missed his last 2 at the free throw line. Iverson is going to return for Larry Hughes. And Ratliff and McKee will also check back in. And it's threatening to make a run here. And Larry Brown puts
Stoppers
back in.
We're going to have to get the story on Scott Williams. I mean, he must have said something somewhere. Directed at these fans in Philadelphia because they are booing when he comes on the floor and giving him an ovation when he gets out.
Something going on there. Hardaway, meanwhile, missed both foul shots. There's still a 7-point Philadelphia lead. Geiger. Well, he's been hot from out there. Matt Geiger has 8 in the quarter, 18 in the game, and the Sixers lead is 9.
Those 2 misses from the free throw line hurt Penny. Let's see if he can get back active.
Andrew defending Austin. Ike trying to get those 2 points back, and Sixers really collapsed in on him. The Magic just can't seem to get a break around the basket tonight, can they? Look at the big guy run the bridge. Iverson passes up the jumper, penetrates into the lane. Aaron McKee. Biggest lead of the night for Philadelphia with 1:03 to play in the quarter. Billy double teaming and a bad pass is stolen by Geiger.
Man, oh man. Because we knew there would be nights like this, but second game of the year.
You know, and last night, the Magic dominated the third quarter as Iverson knocked one in. It was the third quarter last night when Orlando took control against New York. Tonight, Philadelphia is turning the tables on Orlando. They lead by 13 now, inside of 30 seconds to play in the third quarter. Armstrong is tripped up by Iverson as he turns the corner on the pick and roll. Only his third.
And I think the Sixers had one to give, so no free throws coming here.
Horace Grant will return for the Magic. And George Lynch back in the lineup for the 76ers as Outlaw comes to the sideline. And Iverson will check out for Philadelphia. Dribbling the clock down out near midcourt. They run the high pick and roll and see if he can make something good happen. They ran this play at the end of an earlier quarter, and Armstrong and Doliak made it work. Anderson with a 3-point shot. Boy, it could have used that one, but it won't go in, and that's the end of the third quarter. Philadelphia closed the third on a 6-0 run, and they enjoy their biggest lead of the night. They're up and cheering the home team at the First Union Center. Philly on top, 71-58.
Beer is the best it can be at the brewery, fresh and at its peak of taste. Light, heat, and age are all enemies of beer that work against its taste from the moment it leaves the brewery. Budweiser's 12 local breweries ensure that your Budweiser is fresh and has not been subject to long trips. So you might say your Budweiser has less miles on it, and that means it'll taste like it does straight from its source.
Constantly searching for lower prices, Team Target travels here to the Great Barrier Reef. Ordinarily timid creatures, the lower prices periodically emerge from their hiding to feed, reproduce, and be harvested. Careful to take only what they need, Team Target ensures there will be abundant low prices today and for the future.
Do you like a sample?
Don't mind if I do. Good stuff. Can we have some more?
Sure.
Thanks.
Hey, just find a piece.
Hey, it's for the team.
Cheese here. Get your cheese.
No, no, sorry. That's mine. That's later. Okay. That's for me later, too. Take over here.
Okay. Well, what is this about?
Well, Hubie and I on the side are... We make cheese.
Check out our Solar Bears ticket packages starting as low as $66. Call 407-872-PUCK.
Pickle. Love.
Hello, everybody. I'm Ahmad Rashad.
And I'm Summer Sanders.
We hope you're enjoying your free preview of NBA League Pass on DirecTV.
NBA League Pass gives you more exciting NBA games than you ever thought possible.
Call 1-800-GET-SPORTS by February 11th to order NBA League Pass for the special price of $69, a $10 savings off the regular season price.
See up to 40 games a week, all from the comfort of your own living room.
So call now to order NBA League Pass, and we hope you enjoy the rest of your free preview on DirecTV Sports.
We're back in Philadelphia. The fourth quarter is underway, and Snow with the jumper out of the corner. It won't go. Doliak and Hardaway wrestling for the rebound. Magic substitute to start the fourth quarter. Rookies Doliak and Harpering are in the ball game with Armstrong, Hardaway, and Grant.
Penny had a lot of success, David, in that period. We'll see if he stays aggressive offensively.
Harpering has an open jumper. Nice. He drills it. Nice job by Hardaway to get him a shot. Good shots have been tough to come by tonight, Jack. And when they've had them, the Magic have had a difficult time making them.
Exactly.
Bad combination. Shot by McKee, no good, but Iverson with the rebound. His pass deflected. Nice job by Penny. Now it's 3-on-2. Going the other way. Harpering is fouled by Snow. He'll shoot two.
Well, that's a well-executed fast break right there by the Magic. Good job pushing the ball up the floor to Darrell Armstrong. And Penny Hardaway made the real quick move to the basket to force the defense to take him. See Penny with the deflection there, and Darrell Armstrong heads up play to come up with it. And then you'll see Harpering come into the picture right there, and Darrell Armstrong leading the fast break perfectly that time.
And Harpering looked like a rookie the first time he entered the ball game in the first half. But he makes the jump shot, and he gets involved in transition on the offensive end. And off to a good fourth quarter start is Matt Harpering. Four quick points for the rookie from Georgia Tech. Cuts the lead to 9. Hardaway defending McKee. And now Armstrong against Iverson. Ken Thomas has not played much. He's got the ball now. They give it inside. And there is a... Oh, the ball's out of bounds. No foul. Rowlett just lost the handle.
Doliak came over from the weak side. Did a good job of putting on some pressure. Horace Grant had him covered from the upside. He just lost it out of bounds.
Doliak looked very good in the first half. Hardaway on the drive around McKee, the runner in the lane, and he got it.
Kind of looked Theo Ratliff off that time. Theo thought he was going to make the pass, and Penny went on to the basket, and we have, what, a 20-second timeout coming, or is it going to be full? I haven't seen the 20-second timeout signal, so it's a full timeout.
There's your third quarter stats brought to you by Champion. The Magic in the quarter really struggled, only 5 of 17 in the period, Deuce.
Yeah, they are struggling from the field, David, but normally what happens or what you want to get when you're struggling are some baskets, some attempts closer to the basket. Penny Hardaway doing a good job of breaking down the Philly defense. Darrell Armstrong also with some penetration, and the Magic have been able to eat into that 13-point lead just a little bit here.
Well, the Magic off and running in the third quarter. They're on a 6-0 run and have cut the lead back down to 7. Philadelphia had raced out to a 13-point lead at the end of the quarter. So a good start to the fourth period, and there's plenty of time left for the Magic to try and pull it out. The Magic are celebrating their 10th anniversary. Now you can have a chance to become part of the Magical Decade. Here's your opportunity to become a Magic season ticket holder. They are available. Call 407-89-MAGIC today, and don't miss out on the chance to become part of this season-long celebration. A couple of Jack Gibbons' closest friends.
That's the Jack Gibbons fan club right there.
Is that Chip Carey on the left?
It might be Chip. He's had some dead time on his hands right now. Chip never did look that good, though.
No, you're right.
Well, David, the Magic have done what we had hoped they would do eventually, and that is to put together a mini run, at least. 6 straight points for the Magic, and hopefully that's enough to get them started. Obviously, when you're down, you have to make up some points on defense. Let's see if the Magic can get their defensive game working.
Thomas with the jump shot. It won't go. And Doliak, Armstrong came in and knocked it away from his teammate. Iverson makes a three. Boy, that is a big turnaround.
Darrell Armstrong going after that one, kind of knocked it free. That's a big, big basket.
The lead is back to 10. The hustling play by Armstrong, and there's a situation where the hustle didn't work, and a foul is called on the key. Penny Hardaway is just absolutely unguardable tonight by Philadelphia.
He's high energy, really active on both ends of the floor.
If he could get a little more help tonight, the Magic could pull this one out. Look at him go baseline, and then nice dish to Harpering, but it's stripped away, and then a nice save by McKee for Philadelphia. Iverson with the behind-the-back dribble. Going baseline, and then the layup is good.
I just kept his dribble alive, and the Magic kind of let up. Thought he was going to make a pass. Instead, he just took it right onto the basket.
Two big plays by Iverson back-to-back. The three, and now the driving layup. And the Sixers are back up by 12. Michael Doliak with the jumper. Loose ball to Penny Hardaway. He's got Harpering open in the corner for two. He missed it short.
Kind of like what Allen Iverson has done. He struggled so badly from the outside. He went to the basket, got something done there, and then he got the three-point shot to go, and then again took it right onto the basket.
He's feeling it, but not that time. Harpering can't clear the board, and into the hands of Harvey Grant goes the basketball. He's 50 to play in the ballgame.
I think Philly legs maybe a little bit more lively than the Magic. They're coming up with just about every loose ball.
Will work against Grant. Count the basket and the foul against the Magic, it looks like.
Now Doliak gets the foul, and I think Harvey Grant will shoot a free throw. Well, no, they're going to the other end. I think they've made a mistake here. I think Harvey Grant will get a free throw on this end of the basket. Theo Ratliff made it, but the foul came in the act of the shot. So he might get one free throw here. We'll see.
I think that's going to be the call. There's some confusion among the officials. But the man who shot the ball, Ratliff, was not fouled. It was Harvey Grant who was battling with Michael Doliak for rebound position, and Doliak got the whistle. Sixers have their biggest lead now at 14. And Dagger will return for Philadelphia. Well, he and Ratliff done a nice job tonight. We thought the Magic might have the front court advantage in this one, but you combine Ratliff and Geiger, and they've done an excellent job. And Harvey Grant makes the free throw. He's outscored his older brother. Harvey has 5-2. Now a 15-point lead for Philadelphia. Magic go to Hardaway, and he can't find the handle. He gets away from him out of bounds. Doliak with the entry pass, and not a good one.
Yeah, tough angle on that pass from Doliak. He's straight up the lane, tried to feed it to Penny away from the D.
that ball entered from the wing and from up top. Geiger open for the foul line. It is a 17-point lead for the 76ers. 20 points for Matt Geiger. And the Magic stop the clock. But can they stop the bleeding tonight? Philadelphia is on a 10-0 run. And the Magic regroup. So Philadelphia trying to go 2-0 on this young season with a commanding lead against the Magic.
Sure, we had our differences.
It was something we all had trouble with.
But while we were all trying to gain something, we almost lost something.
This is what we forgot.
You, our fans.
The ones we need to look out for.
We need to bring the Magic back to you.
Not just 100%, but 110%. On the court.
And in the community.
Now it's time.
Time to play some ball.
You may notice that my lips aren't moving. Not having me actually on stage saves a lot of money, which is being passed along in the form of a dandy Dodge Durango lease rate. Just $348 a month for a handsomely equipped two-wheel drive Durango, with the best cargo room, passenger room, and power in its class. Dodge Durango. Unlike me, it really moves. See the friendly Dodge dealer near you.
Amor. Amor, my love, amor, amor, make life divine, say you'll be mine, and love me only, amor, amor,
Let's check out the game summary, brought to you by the new Dodge. Check out the new Dodge Caravan, a marvelous vehicle that I've enjoyed driving. Penny Hardaway, 24 points, 9 rebounds. Geiger, 20 points, 4 rebounds. And boy, Geiger and Ratliff have just been terrific tonight for the Philadelphia 76ers.
Dominique Wilkins, his first action in Magic uniform.
And a drive by Overton is good. Dominique on the floor for the first time in a Magic uniform. Last year he played in Italy. There he is. Number 8 all-time leading NBA scorer. And why not put him in right now?
Well, Magic could use some points. And
great hustle by Thomas. The Sixers just battling on the glass, coming up with a lot of loose balls.
Yeah. And that just means he's beating them, David, to everyone that bounces away. 76ers come up with it.
Dominique with the jumper comes up short. And a timeout is taken. Thomas was about to stumble out of bounds with the ball. And he'll take the 20-second timeout. So Dominique Wilkins, who has scored over 26,500 points in his NBA career, this is his first shot at the basket for the Orlando Magic. But what a career Dominique Wilkins has enjoyed. He's 39 years old, still a lot of spring in those legs. He played in the NBA for San Antonio just 2 seasons ago, and he averaged 18 points per game for the Spurs. And the Magic believe that there's still a lot of basketball life in Dominique Wilkins, obviously, signing him on.
Well, this is the kind of game the Magic can find out about that, because the offense is really, really stagnant with everyone except Penny Hardaway. So for Dominique, this is an opportunity for him to get himself a few minutes and maybe get some points on the board for the Magic. One of the things he does well is get to the free throw line.
Matt Geiger on the baseline drive, and a shot blocked for the foul call. Shays checked in, and naturally he gets called for the foul.
Danny Shays and Jeff Turner. If they're around the action and the whistle blows,
count it.
Just give it to them.
A lineup now for the Magic of Overton and Anderson, Dominique Wilkins. Bo Outlaw has just checked in for Horace Grant. A and they join Danny Shays. Tim Thomas at the free throw line. Thomas gives Philly an 18-point lead. Geiger checks out, and he gets a rousing ovation. He's a great basketball fan in Philadelphia. He is a tremendous basketball town. It's been a while since they've had a lot to cheer about.
That's right. That's what I was going to say. They love it when they win.
Yeah. Great college town, Goose. Big five
Big
here.
Five. College is here.
Anderson now lost. Trying to run a pick and roll. Mitch steps back. Long three. Wilkins with the rebound. Dominique got two men off their feet. Through the foul and the basket. Count it for Dominique Wilkins.
He's going to give you some points. If he can't give you anything else, he's going to give you some points. And as I say, he does a great job of getting to the free throw line. So he gets the basket and gets a chance here for three.
Wilkins drafted originally by Utah and quickly traded to the Atlanta Hawks.
Hey,
that was a long time ago.
Went to Atlanta and took over my number 21 and has really made that 21 look good.
That's two pretty good players who wore that jersey.
That's a good number for him.
3-point play for Dominique Iverson. He gets the open shot for Thomas for three.
He makes that shot. He is a very, very difficult player to defend.
Well, last year he shot 36% from behind the arc, so it's not out of his offensive game.
Well, as the season went on, he really got good at knocking down that three-point shot.
Dominique still has respect of the officials, doesn't he?
Yes, he does. You know, that's the veteran play coming out of him there as he understands the comment, the contact will come.
Dominique Wilkins. Missing the first of two. McKee checks out. And Eric Snow returns to the Philadelphia lineup. Nine-time All-Star in the NBA. Dominique. Second shot in and out. 5:49 left. Iverson locks it up. Thomas throws it down. And this crowd just loving it.
Young legs. Young legs.
21-point lead for Philadelphia. Overton with the drive, and he lays it in. Overton, when given minutes tonight, has done a nice job.
He's very crafty off the dribble.
Yeah.
Very much able to break down defenses.
Almost to the five-minute mark. Philadelphia started pulling away in the third quarter when the Magic scored only 11 points. Rallis wasn't looking for the pass. Wilkins got it hung up on his hip. Now Bo Outlaw trying to work his way free for a jumper. Dominique gets in there and gets the offensive rebound, and he's fouled again. Nice job.
He's working hard.
The elder Wilkins.
He wants Mr. Chuck Daly to see him out there hustling and making good things happen. He gets two more free throws here, David. Sixers over the limit. Magic with just two team fouls.
Harvey Grant picked up the foul, his first. Dominique missed two a moment ago and missed three straight. That's something you won't see very often out of Dominique.
That's called conditioning, basketball shape. And that one rolls off.
All around the rim, but they won't fall in. It's that's sort of a indication of the way this whole evening has gone for the Magic. 4.5 minutes to go. Tim Thomas, not that time, and Dominique runs down the rebound.
And I like right here, just giving it to Dominique again on the low post.
And the foul as Overton takes it strong to the hoop again.
Well, he is so quick off the dribble, isn't he?
When you give him any kind of space, and he's there. Remember back, he got 30 points against the Magic in one game.
I remember that night, too.
His career high.
Back in April of 95.
And the other Wilkins off the bench will check into the game.
We're going to witness an NBA first right now. The Wilkins brothers on the court at the same time as Gerald checks in for Nick Anderson. Michael Doliak also will substitute in for Dan Shade. Overton is 3 out of 3 from the field, and he stays perfect at the line as well. Philly by 17 with just over 4 minutes to go in the basketball game. That was defended
nice
by
matchup right here.
Couldn't hold on to it. It's a 3-on-4 fast break. Overton had it stripped by Iverson. Doug arguing for a foul call, but no whistle.
Definitely got hit on the arm.
Iverson's got Gerald Wilkins on him, but he dumps it inside to Ratliff. Now it's past the snow. Not a good look by Ratliff, and Philadelphia turns the ball over. Magic will put it in play with 3:43 to go in the ballgame. Larry Brown looking for his 886th career victory tonight. Professional basketball.
Matt Harpring most likely will come in for Bo Outlaw. Bo, the only starter left.
Dominique shot won't go. Outlaw had it knocked away by Ratliff, and the ball picked up by Snow. It's 1-on-4, now 1-on-5, and Iverson still penetrating to the basket. He missed the shot. Rebound deflected into the hands of Outlaw. .313 to go in the basketball game.
Gerald Wilkins wanted to slow it down, see what he could get from up high.
Foley up to Gerald Wilkins, looking inside for his brother. He'll take the long shot. It won't go. And Ratliff has the rebound for Philadelphia. 2:52 on the clock. And the Magic can hope for better on Monday night back home against the Boston Celtics.
Offensive foul, illegal screen.
Harvey Grant gets called for that one.
Do get a timeout just because we have to.
And it will stop the clock with 2:43 to go in the basketball game. First half, not too bad for the Magic, but it's been all Philadelphia in the second half. And the Sixers are on top by 17 points.
Constantly searching for lower prices. Team Target travels here to the Great Barrier Reef. Ordinarily timid creatures, the lower prices periodically emerge from their hiding to feed, reproduce, and be arrested. Careful to take only what they need, Team Target ensures there will be abundant low prices today and for the future.
While there are a lot of places where people buy parts for their car, the fact is...
Let's take a look at the Bell South slam dunk replay.
Well, Thomas is going to get the alley-oop from Allen Iverson. Boy, he knocks it down from the outside, and he can fly, as you saw on that replay.
And you said it, Goose. Young legs tonight have prevailed.
Yeah, you're right.
Now the 39-year-old legs of Dominique Wilkins misfiring, and McKee gets the rebound for Philadelphia. 17-point 76ers lead, 2:20 to go. And Harpering back into the lineup for the Magic. Doliak and Harpering both on the floor. Gerald strips it away, but Snow recovers it near midcourt. Now the shot clock is at 5. And Gerald Wilkins reaching in is going to be called for the personal. Gerald took the jersey number 9 when his brother Dominique arrived. Well, you get that cleared through the NBA. You can't just,
you can't just change. Although,
change.
You know, the thing is, I think Gerald wanted number 9 before the season started, petitioned the NBA, and they would not allow him to change. And since Dominique has made number 21 famous, they said you can make the move.
Well, Ratliff has had a monster game. not just what you'll see in the
that's right.
in the scorebook tomorrow with 17 points. He's changed a lot of shots. I've been impressed with Philadelphia's team defense tonight. They've really put together a pretty solid defensive ball club in a short period of time. Nice shot by Doliak. A rookie from Utah has 6. And the clock ticking down as Overton trying to steal the ball from Snow, but Philadelphia takes the timeout. So a full timeout for Philadelphia. A minute 27 to go in the ball game, and the Sixers en route to their second consecutive win.
The Magic look to stop the Pistons in Motown Thursday the 11th at 7:30.
Adolphus Busch went to Germany every summer looking at different breweries.
Philadelphia with the basketball and a 17-point lead. A minute 18 to play in the ballgame. Anthony Parker. He got Harpring up off his feet and made the jumper.
It's a big shot. Those shots are a whole lot easier to make in a game like this when you're up and relax.
Wilkins will let it fly. That's Gerald. Dominique with the tip. And Snow with the rebound for Philadelphia. Less than a minute to play in the game. Hughes can't put the ball in on the reverse layup, and the Magic get the rebound. Here's Dominique with the drive, and a foul is called against Casey Shaw, the rookie from Toledo.
Dominique, although he's missed 4 straight free throws, he could make a living right from the line. Gets there an awful lot.
Yes, he does, throughout his career. Just one of the great scorers of all time. And really having a difficult time from the foul line tonight, where he's 1 out of 6, making his debut in a Magic uniform this evening. Penny Hardaway had a solid game tonight. He just couldn't get enough help. And Dominique misses another, but Doliak has the rebound, and they take it away. Well, this has been one for Magic. St. Ems in this ball club probably just as soon as you'd like to forget. Doliak, 19-point Philadelphia game. And a foul on Dominique. Nazi Muhammad will go to the free throw line.
Dominique says, young fella, I can't let you have that. I understand it, but be nice to dunk this one, but I just cannot let you have it. That's from the old school. Make them beat you from the line.
Hard foul on Dominique Wilkins, and Muhammad at the line. Philadelphia gave up a future first-round draft pick to entice Utah to take him with the last pick of the first round last year and trade him. Muhammad, Chicago native, member of Kentucky's national championship team from a year ago. And now has 4 points in the ball game tonight. 20-point Philly lead. And less than 20 seconds now left in the basketball game. Magic going to be 1-1. And the surprising Sixers are going to go to 2-0. Doliak cannot control the ball out of bounds. He was going to flush that
one. Wanted that one, didn't he? Wanted that dunk. Just got a little bit over-anxious and lost control of it.
Sixers will just dribble out the clock. And they celebrate back-to-back victories on this young, short NBA season. And they do it with defense tonight. Their offense not nearly what they were able to do defensively. They scored a lot of points off of turnovers and off of their defensive rebounding. So give them credit. They played an outstanding game tonight. The Magic never really able to find a rhythm in this ball game, and they lose it by 20. We'll be back in just a moment.